People say you should not flick down. If you actually were flicking down, you'd probably look like this. It is even understandable why so many people have to say you should not flick down, because it is obvious that your front foot reaches the ground first by flicking down. But you're not, are you? You are flicking more forward. The strange thing is, even though you're consciously flicking forward, you somehow can't keep your front foot above the board. In fact, under certain conditions, even if you flick forward, the front foot can still be forced downward. This time, I'll explain why the front foot reaches the ground first during a kickflip and how to fix it. You're watching Whythetrick. Please subscribe. The most important thing is to keep your knee in place when flicking. Take a look at my kickflip. If you pay attention to my knee, you'll notice that it barely moves during the flick. Instead, the lower leg swings out from the knee as its pivot point. Let's think through the correct motion of the flick from the beginning. Pop the tail and lift the front knee. The nose rises and pushes back against your front foot. From this position, when you flick, your foot swings in an arc around the knee and transfers rotation to the board. The point is that you must not move your knee. I'll explain this in detail in a moment, but if you extend your leg during the flick, the knee drops and you can no longer keep your front foot above the board. Kicking down with the entire leg might generate more energy than simply swinging the lower leg. However, when you combine the concept of fixing the knee with the principle I explained in the previous video, that swinging the lower leg makes the toe dip first before rising upward, you can transmit enough force to flip the board. I recommend practicing flicking while stepping off the board to get used to this motion. Pop the tail and lift your front knee. Just like in a real kickflip, let the nose push your front foot back so that it gets closer to your body. If you flick while your foot is too far away, the force becomes parallel to the board's axis and won't generate a flip. Always flick close to your center of mass. Keep your knee fixed in one place and swing out your front foot. The direction of flick is vital. Open your front knee and flick the nose sideways. And if your knee is too high or too low, it won't work. Adjust the height of your front knee to match the power of your pop. Once you get comfortable with the feeling of spinning the board, try to land back on it. Also, with the Whythetrick system, you can visualize the position of your knee, so make use of that. In contrast, you can't flick very effectively without fixing your knee. If you try to generate the rotational force on the board without fixing the knee, you end up extending the leg and kicking the board downward. As a result, while the tip of the front foot moves forward, the knee and the entire leg are forcibly pushed downward. Once this force occurs, it is very difficult to counteract, and the front foot ends up touching the ground first. And the disadvantages of not fixing the knee don't end here. If you keep your knee fixed, the force of the nose to rise pushes back against your lower leg. However, if you try to flick by extending your entire leg, you won't be able to bend your knee, and the same upward force from the nose ends up pushing your entire body. As a result, the distance between your body and the board increases, and even if you manage to flip it, you end up shooting it forward instead of keeping it under you. Additionally, the sudden downward push of the front foot triggers a reaction that lifts the back foot. To check whether you fall into this problem, see if your front knee drops during the flick. I recommend practicing flicking with the knee fixed in the air, and getting used to the feeling of flipping the board properly. And that's all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time.